Go.
Hey guys, Bill Spadea here with my co-hosts Jay Black and Jessica Gibson for the Speaking Podcast. Welcome back, guys.
Hi.
Hi.
So, clearly I've not gotten a haircut yet. However, I have fixed the lighting in my office, as you can tell.
It looks fantastic.
I've blocked the windows, I've got soundboard, I've got a plant that is somewhat alive. I'm having a bit of an issue though right now. I can't print.
You can't print?
I don't understand why we've not solved printer issues. Here we are in 2020, and I can't be the only one that for some reason it prints different documents from different accounts. I don't get it.
Bill, can I explain this, but you won't like the answer.
What is the, is it Trump's fault?
It's not Trump's fault. It is one of the flaws. Now, you know, and people don't believe this, Bill, but you know I'm a capitalist. And I like money, and I like how
capitalism. I do. You are not a communist.
Capitalism and uniform standards do not go together. What happens is someone comes up with a print standard, and they go,
"Oh, come on! We figured out the railroads. We figured out the phone lines.
Only when they nationalized them."
No, right? Stop it! AT&T worked just fine before they broke it up.
Listen to me. If it were like, have you seen USB? Everybody's got an idea for how USB works. Nobody knows how it works. USB cables, printer cables, internet, Wi-Fi, all of it is poorly constructed because everybody's fighting together to try to make sure that...
No, see, it's wrong. Eventually, the country comes together and you have a certain standard for CDs, for albums. The problem is we do have all these standards. They just don't work. The technology changes too fast. It makes me crazy. God forbid the government got involved. You'd have a maximum you could print each day. For me, as you know, I print everything because it's the only thing to ensure that the forest will be with us for many, many hundreds of years to come.
I am arguing not for the government to get involved. I'm arguing for the companies to get involved. Like, have the government force the companies to get together and elect a czar whose job it is to make sure that all the standards follow the same one. And then you'd have something that you could print. All I want is to be able to print too, and we can't because these printer companies can't get their crap together.
I had to have such an argument with Chase about how we had to have a printer in our house. He thinks that printers are old and outdated and no one needs them anymore.
It is kind of like a fax machine.
All right, now here we go. I'm gonna try again. I'm pressing print. You can hear it going. Wait a minute. I need one copy.
Your kids aren't here to help you with this?
Yeah.
This is the issue, right? I don't understand. I even bought a new printer last week just to solve the problem. Like, I bought a printer so I could print. I threw away a printer that wouldn't print and bought a new printer.
Is it my printer?
It's made, listen, oh, here we go. Do you hear it? Wait. It's the big reveal.
Jay, you have a printer, right?
I have two printers.
And I have done it. It took 9 tries and 15 sheets of paper, and it's done.
Exactly how many it was for me to conceive my third child.
I can rest easy now. So here's an update. I am getting a haircut an hour before our next podcast.
What? Oh. So you're getting a haircut?
That's kind of a big deal.
Are you going somewhere to get a haircut, or are you bringing somebody in?
No, I don't wear a mask, Jay. Are you kidding? I haven't worn a mask since this insanity started. I have someone coming to my house.
Can we record on Mondays so that we can see how bad it is before the haircut?
So here's what I'll do. I will take a, you know, it's not a bad idea, but whatever, I will take a, there will be a video, Jessica. So it's gotten a little out of control. Here's what I learned. I've been using my glasses to prop up my hair. Now, here's the interesting thing. You are now blurry. So I found myself earlier today using the glasses to prop my hair up and then the second pair to see. So it's gotten out of control. During my Facebook Live this morning, one of the young producers decided that it is long enough to be French braided. So it's very possible before we hit record, there in fact may have been a French braid.
Wow.
Yeah. Scary, actually.
Yeah, you've gone from like guy who's trying to save the environment after a yoga class to a creepy English professor at a girls' college in 1958.
You know what bothers me, Jay? your descriptions often involve the word creepy.
Have some truth to them.
You know what? You write what you know, Bill. You write what you know.
I was thinking more like one of those surfers who thinks it's the best time to go out surfing is right before the big hurricane comes out.
Oh yeah, you're Patrick Swayze in Point Break.
Do this. Hold on. I'm gonna come right back. I have to return this call. It's gonna take literally 45 seconds, and I will be right back.
All right, hold on. I'm timing you.
Time me.
All right, let's see if Bill can actually pull it off.
Can he actually get back into the Skype room?
You know, he can. I guess he can request back in. So we're at 5 seconds. We'll see if he can get back. Jessica, how has your plague week been?
Literally nothing has happened. What do you tell people when they ask you what's new? I'm like, nothing's changed. I don't know. Nothing's going on.
Yeah, generally speaking, the pause that follows how are things is so long and disturbing, the person just moves on without asking a follow-up.
It's like, ugh.
I will tell you the very big news, Jessica. What? Huge news. This is going to blow your mind. We finally got an in-tech pool delivered to our house.
Congratulations.
We only had to pay $100 over retail. It's amazing. This is after the first attempt of getting an eBay in-tech pool resulted in us having to call the credit card company for fraud. The second one actually came. It's only the middle of August, but with global warming, it should give us, you know, pool days well into September. And we are one of the lucky families that have a pool now.
I've been driving around. I was looking at a different neighborhood I hadn't been to before. And I was like, why does everyone have these in-tech pools in their backyards? They're like a hot commodity.
They're a super hot commodity. By the way, we're at a minute 30. Bill's word is not good.
What is he doing?
I think it's probably the phone sex company is calling him about a missed payment.
I was just wondering, I feel sad that we have no events to look forward to.
Well, I mean, we had kind of events with Gene, but I guess that's not happening.
It was like around mid-September we had stuff booked.
Right, but like, can he, I keep thinking, why can't he set something up in the parking lot?
Well, I guess he has his like dinner there versus like whereas, you know, other comedy clubs are serving things in the parking lot, but they don't have like a full restaurant for full dinners.
Well, how about this? We charge everybody $200 and then he can make his money. Oh, excuse me one second. Let me. Hey guys, can we all be louder? Can we be louder? All of you?
What happened to your tent?
No, I'm only joking, guys. I had to pull down the tent. I'm sorry, son. I had to pull the tent down because my son, by the way, we didn't get a chance to talk about it. Hold on. What happened?
Nothing.
There's a big somebody fell or something.
I fell.
So the reason why there was a tent behind me, everybody. Bill, you're sideways again, Bill.
By the way, that was really fast.
2 minutes and 40 seconds. A little bit less than 45, Bill.
Here's the biggest issue, though. Why can I not see you guys?
Now, can you see us now? We can see you.
Ah, there we go.
There.
I can say this.
They went under the blue screen. Where'd the blue screen go?
So here's the thing. I had a blue screen up because my son started a YouTube channel. I will put the link to the YouTube channel in the notes. So if you're listening to this podcast and you want to see my son do goofy stuff on YouTube, but he did a makeshift blue screen, which is cool. I was really happy he did that. And I was going to leave it up through the podcast so he wouldn't have to redo it. But I was cooking like an egg. Like I was beginning to boil from the inside out, so I had to get rid of it. It's so hot under there.
It was hot under the blue screen? Was it made of plastic?
Well, it's not a real blue screen. It's a blanket from upstairs. It's the color blue. So he can key onto it and do the stuff that he wants.
Is the blue screen better than the green screen?
Not really, but we don't have any green sheets. We had a blue.
Well, even if you did, you're wearing a green shirt, so you'd be a floating head right now. And
right.
It would be awfully.
I'm upset that we don't have listeners that care enough to actually like use this green shirt to key in goofy stuff like my head's coming out of a flower pot or something. That'd be nice. Get on to that, speaking listeners.
Nice.
So Jessica, let me get a thumbs up or down on now the background, the lighting. Like I spent the week even, huh? All right, what would you change? Come on, that's it.
No, it's good. The plant is alive.
Guys,
I even bought, look at this. Wait, look at this. I even got shelf organizers. Come on.
Wow. Oh, look at that. Wow.
That is so satisfying.
I would have those. I would have those filled with comic book figurines. Ooh, sound dampeners.
Sound. Hold on.
Have you done a broadcast from that room yet? From home.
I am let's see. We're going to start it. We're going to do it on August 10th, and now we're going to do first week in September, and we'll see how it goes. I'm kind of excited. Sound quality in here is good. I even put this. Watch this. Hold on. I completed the look by putting it on the back of the door.
Yeah.
So I feel like the room is somewhat complete. My whole goal is to do future TV projects from here as well. And I actually think it sounds okay. I'm not echoey, am I?
Bill, you got to go to the Room Raiders Twitter. There's a Twitter feed that all it does is rate rooms for all the people that are Skyping in to news stations.
That's funny.
Yeah, so like,
so funny.
And it's gotten into the heads of all these people because like, you'll see them like do a hit on like one of the stations and then immediately tweet at like Room Raiders like, well, I changed the background because you guys are giving me crap about it. So like, if you want to know how to set it up, go to Room Raiders at Twitter and figure it out.
I can't wait. You know what? After my next hit, I'm starting up again after September 1st. But once that happens, I can't wait. I like to be judged by others.
Yeah, bring it up. Tell them.
It helps.
Tweet at them and say, bring it on. I want to get my rating. But they're like a big force now.
It's all about having your photos angled, right? Like on the wall.
Yeah. Really?
That's like probably the biggest thing.
Well, and a lot of people have like bookshelves behind them that are either messy or like, you know, they don't have books that people believe they read. Yeah, no, come on. It's beautiful.
Are you serious?
Jay, did you start putting your stuff in bins in your room? Or did you just angle the camera so we can't see the
No, my wife is actually here. Let me angle the camera. We're not 100% done yet, but look.
Whoa!
Look at what she did.
Whoa! Jay, what happened to the couch?
We got rid of the couch.
The garage? Where's the couch?
So that couch, you know, you had little kids, Bill. You know what little kids do to couches. That was the couch that we had when we first got married. And all three kids, like, we threw it away, but before we threw it away, we cut it open to see like what had seeped down inside of it. And
that's
it was like doing an archaeological dig through Chinese plastic of toys of the last 15 years. It was gross.
Oh, that's
was that?
Or did you get any money?
No, the opposite of money. It felt like I felt like we had to pay cash to get rid of this stuff. It was so gross.
I feel like you should, it's a biohazard at some point. You may have needed a shower afterwards.
Well, no, I got myself one of those radiation suits.
You're all set.
So, yeah. By the way, I have breaking news, guys.
What is that thing behind you, Jay? What is that thing? You see that thing right there? Yeah, there. What is that?
That is a vacuum.
Really?
Yeah, it's like the top. Here, let me see.
Looks like a vacuum.
So Jessica, I put up soundproofing and blackened out the shades. You've got your shades closed, good lighting. Jay just did not care enough to even close the blinds on the window right behind it.
The angle of the camera, so like there was nothing to see here.
Yeah. Bill, you remember when I started though, I was underneath the tent. So I thought that it wouldn't be a problem. But then I had to not go to the tent because I was starting to die.
Got it.
You know what I have when I open these blinds, and I don't think you'll be able to see it, but across the street from me, right when quarantine started, my neighbor demolished their house, and I've been watching it get rebuilt from the ground up all of quarantine.
Really?
The best entertainment you could ask
for. Like the entire house?
You should do a time lapse, like take a picture each day.
Oh, yeah. I mean, there's like big bucket trucks, big yellow trucks out there.
Well, wait, is it like completely demolished? Are you using hyperbole? Or is it like just like a couple of rooms?
Like they took it down from the ground. Like the basement got demolished even. Like everything got taken out. And they're rebuilding the house.
Yeah, I'm sorry. You're not picking up the background noise, I hope, in my house.
Oh, yes. It's very loud in your house. There's actually a party going on.
You can hear all of it?
I feel a little left out.
Yeah, guys, yeah, guys.
Sounds like you got a lot going on there, Jed. No, guys, I think it's okay.
I need you all to be quiet.
Are you curious,
please,
as to what that black writing is behind Jay? Because I am.
Oh, it's like, I think it says, oh, yeah, the Spanish flu ended the World War II. That's what it says.
Interesting. There's a lot to unpack in the Jay Black household during quarantine.
Yeah. What was that?
When this all started, you were calling COVID the Spanish flu. I feel like they are not comparable whatsoever at this point.
Agreed.
How so? Like, not as bad or not as good?
Not as deadly.
Well, I mean, I think part of that is we have, like, hospitals now, and people, like, in Europe are not going to, like, a mud hut to die.
What do you think medical care was like in the mud hut?
I mean, probably better than Arkansas. But still not great, would be my guess.
Look, Jay, Arkansas could be on the list of potential movie sites. Let's not knock anyone right now.
That's a good point. Yeah, Arkansas.
They're all good. From Bulgaria to Arkansas, they're all good. They're all good fellow humans.
That's right. Bulgaria is doing a great business in movies right now. Because
going to Bulgaria for a movie?
Yeah, well, you can't bring people from America, really, to go to Bulgaria for a movie. But, like, Bulgarians will make your movie for you.
I was just, that's a, like a storyline in Schitt's Creek.
Oh, it's building, no, I haven't seen that.
You have not seen Schitt's Creek? Schitt's Creek is fantastic. Jessica, it's a great show.
We'll just peer pressure you to watch it every week until you start watching
it. Jessica, have you watched Dark?
No, what's that?
Oh, all right, so Netflix original. Jay, you might like this. It is a multiple universe time travel mind-bending show where each character exists in different places. It's very cool. It's well done.
All right. Well, it's a German show.
Oh, it's been out for a while too.
Yeah, I just started it. It's three seasons. So confusing though. I have to admit I've had to watch episodes twice.
Well, that sounds like Cloud Atlas. Have you ever heard of that movie or book?
Oh, the Tom Hanks, right?
Yes, but I couldn't get into the movie. I watched it on a plane once in the days when we used to travel, and I couldn't get into it. It was too weird. Did you like it?
Well, I thought it was okay. I kind of knew what I was getting into, but Chase was like, I have no idea what's going on. And then this Dark show sounds like the same concept.
Is it in German?
Good, because it's a series, so you have time to unpack it. It kind of begins and ends in the series. In the episode.
Do they speak in German?
No, it's dubbed. Which is, the truth is, I don't mind subtitles.
Yeah, I prefer subtitles. I want to hear what the actors are saying, even if I don't understand it, and then I'll read it. And, like, I enjoyed Parasite. I don't think I would have liked it as well if they had hired actors to dub over the voices. I don't think that at all.
Still, Parasite has nothing on Train to Busan.
Oh, Train to Busan is wonderful. Yeah, it's the zombie movie, right?
It's a Korean zombie movie. Jessica, have you seen it?
No, I'm Googling it.
Yeah, I don't think Korean zombie movies up Jessica's alley. I could be wrong. Doesn't feel
How
like
do you
this.
Spell Train Busan.
B-U-S-A-N.
Busan. Yeah, and it's the same director, right?
Yeah.
We did both.
It's brilliant. I mean,
I got to be honest. That's what I love about South Korean film is, like, generally speaking, if you do a zombie movie, you don't get to make the quiet drama about class distinctions. You're basically just the zombie movie director or the monster movie director. I like that they have a little bit more leeway in, like, hey, I did this, but now I want to do a movie about class. And they're like, yeah, sure, here's your money. Go for it, man. Like, I dig that. We don't do that here.
Interesting.
Well, if you heard that, the guy who directed, I don't know, Fast and Furious was going to do a period drama set during, 1908, butlers in England, you'd be like, what? No, that you blow up cars. You don't do this. Like, sort of define people by a genre here.
Well, you get cast typed, right? But I don't know. I think it depends. I think Keanu Reeves is the same actor in every movie when it comes to actors.
Well, I mean, that's actors, though. I'm talking about directors. Like, actors, when you hire a movie star, you don't hire them to do a character. You hire them to be themselves.
But you're in that level of business. Like, I think for me, or I don't want to speak for you, Jessica, but probably the same thing. I don't even consider the director.
Oh, really?
Yeah. You know what I consider? the production company. Yeah. You think I'm kidding? You think I'm kidding? And that's a Exit 19 comment. It's actually not. There are certain production companies that you know when you see it come up, the movie's going to be decent, at least worth a try.
Like A24.
A24 and Magnolia.
Magnolia is a good one. Yep.
Those two. If I see that, I'm like, okay. I'll
see. But you don't have like a handful of directors, Bill? Like when Quentin Tarantino does a new movie, I stop everything. And on that day, I'm going to go see the Quentin Tarantino movie regardless.
See, I purposefully do not watch Quentin Tarantino movies. As brilliant as he is, I can't get over his comments about the NYPD. So I've not watched one in a couple of years. And I realize from an entertainment standpoint, it's a huge sacrifice.
Oh,
Pulp Fiction, one of my all-time favorites.
He is the biggest genius working.
What's a bigger sacrifice? Not going to Starbucks or not watching Tarantino movies?
A great point. I don't know. I have to tell you, through this whole nightmare, which I think, my opinion totally overblown, et cetera, but that aside, my habits have changed in a way of the money I've saved every week. It's shocking. Yeah. I had no idea. I mean, we cook, right? Jody's a great cook. I like to cook. We cook. We still had no idea how often we were going out. Meeting people, and you're grabbing a drink, you're doing this. And also at the end of the day, you're like, oh my God, how did I just spend all that money? Mm-hmm. Boom, stop cold in March.
As a former person who liked to ingest chemicals, I thought about like all the people who sort of forcibly detoxed over the course of the last 6 months.
That and worse, right? There, I think there was the other side. Sadly, that is also happening.
Oh, you think there's people who are ODing because, they figure what
they have? Well, they say that the numbers have really spiked up. It's sad. People need structure. They need socialization. But, I have, for the first time in many, many years, considered, I did not do it, but there were times during quarantine, I'm like, I miss smoking cigarettes.
Oh, boy. Yeah.
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 Your drinking's gone up?
I guess alcohol sales probably didn't go up because there's not like concerts and stuff to go to.
I don't know. Right. I don't know. I think casual, I'll say this, having wine with dinner, way up.
Right.
Drinking, not as much because you're not, I don't know. Now, we're seeing more people now, but in the beginning, nobody was doing anything. So it wasn't like, I don't know, you weren't having the parties. It wasn't that socializing. But, I would say we've normalized the wine with dinner, which I like.
Do you guys, I don't know if this is a bad sign or not, but are you like me and you see that it's like 6 o'clock and you're like, all of a sudden, oh my God, it means I get to go to bed soon. This is great. We made it through another day.
Huh? No, I'm like at 6 o'clock. I can watch two more dark episodes.
I'm like, bedtime, let's go.
When it's bedtime, it's the best time. It means I'm going to bed. I got through a day. I'm out of... I'm one step closer to whatever we're headed towards.
See, all that sounds great, except I have a dog problem. So Elizabeth, my daughter, went back, finally got her visa approved. She went back to London over the weekend. Callie, though, my foxhound boxer, very attached to Elizabeth because she's been home for almost a year.
Yeah.
And she's a mess. She goes into our room, goes into Elizabeth's room. We're now getting up at 1 o'clock, and I get up at 3:30 normally. Right. So the dog is not settled. It's been 3 days and we haven't hit a routine yet.
Well, they're saying that that's going to happen to all our dogs once we go back to work. That the dogs are now conditioned to have us home all the time. And there's going to be...
Jay, you're never leaving the house again. Who are you kidding? Because you're never leaving the house. You're going to do your stand-up from there.
Bill, so you are looking at a guy who has two thoughts in his head at the same time. One, I am very afraid of this virus. Two, I'm a big believer in vaccines. Once they get a vaccine, Bill, I'm going to take a shot right in my eyeball, and then I'm going to go cartwheeling through the streets.
So I will not be taking that vaccine, but that's a whole other story. But, I don't even get the flu shot. I used to. And then I'm like, I'm a little meh on it. I don't buy it. It's too rushed. I think it's way overblown, but we could have a three-hour conversation on that. But do not worry. I will pepper you all with many, many articles over the next.
Don't worry. Wait, what is he doing?
There you are.
Yeah, no, I'm going to look like a porcupine. There's going to be so many needles sticking out of my back. Worry about me.
No, hot yoga, baby. Hot yoga. Build your immune system.
I thought you went away to pull up your articles. I was like, he's going to go get
them. I actually, somebody texted, so I tried to you know, swipe it. Hey, what'd you do? You moved.
What? I plugged into my...
Oh, those are great plants, those spiky leaves.
The only one I can't kill. Everything else dead.
Yeah.
This one, the chicken.
That's just like God with members of my family. I'm the only one he couldn't kill. The other four, dead.
Oh, my God. Jessica, we're going to have to work on Jay. We're going to have to get him over his overcome his fears. Eventually, we'll have an intervention, Jay. I'm going to give you a year, though.
I've been through one of those. I've been through one of those, Bill. What's that?
Are you giving him until February or until, like, this time next year?
I think this time next year, and then we're going to talk about an intervention. And it may just be as simple as a motorcycle rally in Bridgewater with the Eagle Riders. Who called the show today, by the way.
I was listening, by the way.
Did you hear me?
Oh, Larry.
Larry was great. I love Larry. I love it.
I also heard about Mike Tomasino on...
Oh, my God. Yeah,
he passed away.
How did he die? What, Jessica, you told me he was sick. What did he have?
I had no idea, though, like, it was anything that would be leading to that. You know, I probably came so young, so...
That's so sad. He was a nice guy. He was easy to work with. I liked him. Jay, did you know him well?
Yeah, well, I mean, I don't know well. I think, you know, the same way that you guys know him, just when we did the gigs there, but he was always a really nice guy to me. And for those of you that don't know, he was the manager at Catch a Rising Star in Princeton, where we've done a bunch of shows, and I've done a bunch of shows. And, you know, it's a shame. I don't know exactly how he passed, but it sucks that he did.
Yeah, it's sad. It's sad. I heard about it actually listening to Trev Elise. I find myself listening to Trev at night. You know, he's a pretty entertaining guy.
Oh, he's a good dude. I like Trev a lot.
Yeah, I like Trev. I'm looking forward. Eventually, we will be back on stage. There will be a show at some point.
Well, I was just talking to Jessica while you were on your 2 minute and 45 second phone call. Not that we,
we're counting.
But we should do an outdoor show. Why can't we get an outdoor show going?
Because I want to be indoors. That's why. It's too freaking hot out. Are you crazy?
Well, September.
I want to be indoor, sitting in front of the air conditioner.
Let's shoot for September outdoor. It'll be nice, crisp fall air.
All right, maybe October for that. We'll see. Hey, look, it all depends on the price.
Hey, let's do Oktoberfest. I can break out my lederhosen.
Ooh. Sitting around in your closet.
All right, Jay and lederhosen. We will end it on that. As we're going to consider that a high note. Oh my God.
Works for me.
All right. So look, next week I will actually have had a haircut. You will be seeing the haircut within an hour of the final trim. So.
Oh my God.
All right. I can't wait. And by the way, everybody, Twitter update. I am up 510 followers from last week. I am now at 370 followers, 3,670 followers, up 500 from last week. Follow me, Jay Black is funny on Twitter. I want to get another 500.
See, Jay, when you said 370, up 500, I assume Twitter, just because this is how the universe treats Jay Black, started you negative.
No, I did drop a lot when I first started tweeting again, when people realized, oh my God, this guy still exists. But I've been adding people since then. I'm at 3,670. I want to be at 4,000 by the time we meet next week.
All right, so let's get Jay to 4,000 at Jay Black is funny.
Right.
Awesome.
Perfect. All right, thanks, guys.
So next week, see you, Jay. See you, Jessica. Bye.